Now, we're breaking down other big moments in today's Pop Talk Live segment.
And Maria D'Antonio, co-host of the Wide Awake Morning Show on Y108, joins us live with the scoop. And, you know, this was a star-studded event, including the glamour shown in the masks. There were multiple stages. It was a big night.
Oh, it was a huge night, and I have to be honest with you, I loved how they set up the performances. They had a big, since they couldn't have an audience, had a big round room with five stages, and Trevor Noah, the host, was kind of in the middle, and each of the artists were at a different stage, and they all got to watch each other. It was pretty entertaining to see it done that way.
And so we showed a clip there of Bruno Mars. That was a pretty incredible performance. Tell us about that and some of the others.
Oh, Bruno Mars, well, he was a last-minute performance ad.
Right.
They actually
right.
had a Twitter campaign last week. He and Anderson .Paak, their new band, Silk Sonic, with their new album coming out, they were like, we want to be on the Grammys. So they did this big Twitter campaign, and they got on, and they had this, like, super 70s setup. It was very Saturday Night Fever, mm-hmm. which I love what they're doing. But the song is called Leave the Door Open, and, man, I was swooning.
Yeah.
So, and the night opened with Harry Styles. We also saw Taylor
yes.
Swift perform too.
Taylor Swift was nothing but magic. I swear to you, I mean, just her whole vibe, from her red carpet look that was totally floral to her set, which you can see right now, moss everywhere, looks like fireflies are everywhere. She was barefoot, glitter nail polish, and she did a medley from her Folklore album. She did Cardigan, August, and Willow, and it was, I could have gone for a full hour of it.
Now, she wrote this, you know, in a cabin in the woods, did she not? So this was kind of perfect setting for her performance.
Exactly. It was exactly what her two albums that came out last year were, Folklore and Evermore. So, I mean, she perfectly fit the vibe.
All right, let's talk about some of the winners, because history was made last night, mm-hmm. and we should start talking about Beyonce first, right?
Beyonce made history last night. I can't even believe this. She broke a record, won her 28th Grammy last night. She is now the most awarded woman in Grammy history. Can you believe? Like, I couldn't even imagine winning one Grammy, let alone 28.
Well, and yeah. not only that, but her daughter walks away with one too. So it's like, she gets yeah. some hardware, and she's 9 years old, you know? So it's a big night for the family.
Yeah. Huge night for the family. 9-year-old Blue Ivy's taking home her Grammy. Mom takes home now her 28th Grammy. I mean, it's a good night to be part of the Carters.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Taylor Swift, another winner too, right?
Yes, Taylor Swift won Album of the Year for Folklore. Billie Eilish won Record of the Year for Everything I Wanted. And Song of the Year went to her for I Can't Breathe. So it was an incredible night.